the Friday of the 10th week in the ordinary time. From the readings that we have today, I want us to focus on this idea of pursuit of righteousness. In the Gospel, Jesus did not only speak about conjugal love of people being faithful to their spouses, or of divorces and separations, etc. But when he said, if you commit sin by your eyes, gouge it out. If you commit sin by your hand, take it out, etc. Better to enter into life of heaven with only one arm or one eye than all of our body be thrown into Gehenna or Gehenna. The idea here is righteousness. To pursue the life of righteousness. To pursue the life that is good, that is godly, that is truthful. When we come to the first reading, here comes God revealing himself to Prophet Elijah. We continue the stories during this week, Prophet Elijah's story. Here, God revealed to the prophet, not through fire or earthquake or thunder, etc., but through a gentle breeze, through silence, through gentleness. And Prophet Elijah went and talked to the Lord. The idea here is this. In our daily life, God is always at work. But he is at work in ways that we do not expect. In every moment, God is always present. And that is why, in the context of righteousness, in the context of holiness of life, in the context of goodness, all we have to do is always be aware of his presence. And when we are aware of God's presence, surely we will be ashamed to be doing foolishness because he is present. Surely we will try to change our bad attitudes and truly strive and strive, even if we fall, but we strive, be in the right path, choosing the right thing, doing what is good. I believe this is the word of God we have for today. How are you and I trying to strive in the life of righteousness? How do you personally walk and seek righteousness? Let us answer this question personally. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.